Hello, welcome to the Milk and Honey Distillery here in hot and humid Tel Aviv. Tomer Goren, the head distiller, is next to me. My name is Tal. The distillery is located in Tel Aviv. The weather and climate is very hot and very humid. That means we have very fast maturation. We lose a lot of angel share, around
10 to 11%.
Okay. Annually. But we gain it in very fast maturation. So that means that 3 years for us, it's a lot in a cold country.
It feels much more than in a cold country.
Yeah. What are we going to taste first, Tomel?
I think we'll start with the classic.
So, this whiskey is an everyday whiskey. It's a whiskey for everyone.
It's based on ex-bourbon and STR cask. STR, it means shave, toast, and recharge. It's a technique to treat casks that developed by Dr. Jim Swan that we worked with from the beginning of the distillery. I like to call it table whiskey.
Yeah.
It's really drinkable, easy drinking, and really nice bottle at 46 ABV.
Non-chill filter. So you can feel a lot of vanilla, some
a lot of
nuts.
Vanilla and caramel from the ex-bourbon. You have some nuts in the finish.
Fruitiness, maybe from the red wine.
Slight spiciness that I really like. Cheers.
Cheers.
Chaim.
The texture is very oily, very thick.
Yeah, that's because the line arm goes 45 degrees down in our stills. If you add just a little bit of water to it, it opens a lot of vanilla flavors.
A bit of floral notes. Cheers. We're going up to the second series, or our series, the Element series, which we actually, it's based on the same casks as the classic, but adding another element for each whiskey.
That's right. It's based on ex-bourbon cask and STR cask, just like the classic whiskey. And then we add another cask type to each element, sherry, peated cask, and the Israeli red wine casks.
When you taste the whole series, I think you can discover our style. So it's not overwhelming, nothing is overpowering, because we wanted each one to find his own whiskey in our portfolio.
The first one will be Israeli red wine casks.
Okay.
We have a lot of really interesting wineries in Israel.
Israel has around 3,000, 4,000 years old wine culture, but these modern age wineries are making excellent wines in our climate, so it's a bit different. Great variety, or just different, totally different terroir that gives a lot of character to the cask that we're using.
So here you really feel the wine cask coming up in the nose.
It's not a very winey whiskey, but you can feel the wine, you can feel the red fruits and a little bit of the oak.
Yep. It's got full body, and I really like
coating.
The finish. Finish is really long, with dark chocolate.
Yep, pearlins. Cherries. A very nice finish.
Yep, very nice long finish. The second element is the peated.
As we call it, lightly peated.
Yes, it's really lightly peated. Again, balanced, 46 ABV.
In this whiskey, specifically, we are not using a peated barley. All the peat and the smokiness and the earthiness comes from ex-Isla or ex-peated casks.
That's right. In the next batches of this, we will use peated barley.
Yeah, we have peated barley, but it's not old enough.
So you do feel peatiness in the nose, but it's not overwhelming. You do feel the other casks and the character
herbs,
of the new make.
Okay. Herbs, earthiness, spiciness, some mint, something like that. Very fresh.
And the peat
comes in the palate
comes
more.
Comes in the palate. You feel it really nice. It mixed with the other taste really nice.
I think it's a peated whiskey for someone that is just starting to discover the smoky whiskies.
Yeah, that's nice.
Cheers.
Cheers.
The next one is
the sherry, Elements sherry. And here we got a really interesting story about the cask. So we couldn't source any kosher sherry casks, and we are kosher.
The problem with kosher is the wines. You can make a kosher whiskey any day, but when you're using wine cask, it has to be kosher. So of
That's
course,
right.
The Israeli red wine casks are kosher wineries, but the sherry is a problem. We don't have sherry in Israel.
Yeah, so what we had to do is to make a contract with the winery, with the bodega, and with the cooperage, and to bring the rabbi from Barcelona to produce our sherry in south of Spain.
So actually the rabbi supervised the whole procedure?
The whole process of making the sherry, and we were there. We know the wine is really good.
So we're monitoring the wine production and the cask seasoning, and it's great for us because we're not just finding or buying sherry cask from a broker.
We know exactly what we buy.
This one is a combination of two kinds of sherry, PX, Pedro Jimenez, and Oloroso in two sizes, sherry butts of 500 liters and hogsheads of 250 liters.
So it's really nice whiskey. It's got a lot of red fruits.
But dark fruits, some
dark
dried fruits
also.
Very rich. But very light, it's not a sherry bomb like you said.
It's very easy drinking, but you do feel the sherry notes, sherry cask.
Very dark chocolate in the finish. Cheers.
Cheers.
The next whiskey we're gonna taste, it's something you have in your tasting kits. It's a preview of what we're gonna do when we go crazy. This one was aged in a pomegranate wine casks. Yes, pomegranate wine cask.
Wow, that sounds interesting. So we have a really big winery here in Israel, in north of Israel, that produces fruit wine from pomegranate.
Pomegranate is a part of our culture. It was cultivated here in the Middle East, and we eat a lot of pomegranates. It's a part of our ceremonies in the holidays. We drink juice, we eat a lot of salads, and of course we have a pomegranate winery that we are actually taking their casks and age our whiskey in.
And it's something, besides being really Israeli, it's really innovative. I don't think there are a lot of, if there are any
pomegranate wineries,
whiskey makers that yeah. use pomegranate wine casks.
So the first scent, you feel a little bit of the tartiness, sourness from the grains itself, but also lots of red fruits.
You feel the tannic, the
yeah.
tannins.
Very dry, but then you feel the fruits, the red fruits.
And it's got a really nice combination between sweetness from the wood and sour from the pomegranate.
And it's also, it was bottled at 55 ABV, so you can actually add a little bit of water. With a drop of water, you can actually feel the fruit itself a little bit more, and it combines great with the new make, with the sweetness of the new make.
Cheers.
Cheers. So the pomegranate wine cask is a glimpse of a little bit of our future, of our playground, of Thomas' crazy mind. A series called Apex, it's the third tier. Tomer, can
and
you describe it?
It will contain small batches or single cask, all bottled at cask strength. And it's everything that we find interesting or...
crazy.
Or crazy.
The good thing about being a craft distillery, we can play. And if we think the game was good, we're going to bottle it. And this one was exceptionally good.
The pomegranate is a really nice example for the...
But we're also going to have some white wine casks and casks that we aged in crazy places and different kind of atmosphere that in Tel Aviv. So this is the Apex.